Hello learners, in this lecture we'll see what are the systems of aircraft parking. So the in the system of aircraft parking we have four different systems. The first is called as frontal or linear system. The second is open apron or transporter system. The third is pier or finger system, and the last one what we have is a satellite system. So coming to the frontal or the linear system, you can see it here we'll be having a terminal building. This is the apron area. So this is called as frontal or linear system. So in the linear system, what happens? We'll have a terminal building, and the aircrafts what we have now, they're going to be parked here, right? So coming to the theory part, frontal layout of facilities is usually at airports of low activity, wherever there is no much, takeoff, landing and all, where there is activity of less importance, less activity, then we try to go with the frontal or linear system. In this system, the aircraft are parked along the face of the terminal building. So this is a terminal building, and to the face of the terminal building, we are going to park the aircraft here. It usually has an apron providing close-in parking for 3 to 6 commercial passengers aircraft. You can see the apron here as well. So it is very simple and economical system. The frontal concept offers ease of access and relatively short walking distances. It also affords a high degree of flexibility for the expansion. Just in case if you want to do the expansion and all, then it offers a high degree of flexibility for the expansion. Yeah, and here you have a terminal building, and here itself the aircraft is parked, right? So what will happen? The frontal concept offers ease of access and relatively short walking distances. So from the terminal building, if you want to board the flight, then the distance from here is very short. So it will provide an ease of access to the aircraft. Yeah. The next is a open apron or a transporter system. So here again, what will happen? You have a terminal building here. This is an apron provided here. So it's an open apron here. It's a terminal building, and you can see the aircraft kept here. So in this system, the aircraft are parked in rows, right? You can see the aircraft which has been parked, they're parked in the rows. Even here also, you can see that. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they have been parked in a, the aircrafts have been parked in a row. If the number of aircrafts is too large, passenger may have to walk long distances or reach the aircraft parked in the outermost row. They are thus exposed to weather, noise, and hot blast of the jet aircraft. To protect the passengers from such nuisance, some sort of closed vehicle conveyance for the passenger may be essential, right? So this is another way of parking facility. Again, you can see there is a surface access, and all these are the aircraft which have been parked here in a row. So this is called as open apron or the transporter system. The next one what we have is a pier or finger system. So again, in this we have, first we'll see here. So this is a pier or a finger system. Finger system project onto the parking apron and permit the aircraft to park closer to the terminal. This arrangement reduces the structural cost since loading is accomplished on both the side. It can be a T shape, a straight or a Y shape. So you can see a T shape here. This is a straight parking and this is a Y shape. So this one looks like a T shape, hence it is called as T shape. So this is straight here and this is a Y shape. So you have a processing from here, and these are the pier or the finger system. Walking distances to the extreme end positions, however, could be rather long, right? If you're coming from here, then to the extreme position, if you want to take up this aircraft, then what will happen? The walking distances to the extreme end positions, however, could be long, right? And here you can see the aircraft have been parked here, and this is a terminal building. From here, you'll have an access. Yeah. And the last one, what we have is a satellite system. Satellite has small buildings located on the aprons. You can see it here, no? So this is a satellite what we have. And close to that, what we are going to have, we are going to park the aircrafts here. So there is one satellite, second, third, and fourth satellites. And this is a connector for one satellite to the another satellite. Aircrafts are parked around the satellite building, which are connected to the main terminal building by an underground tunnel, right? So this is a terminal building here. You can see a small, same system here, right? Here you can see the aircraft have been parked here, right? Yeah. So it is completely surrounded by the aircraft, connected to the processing areas of the terminal via underground, at grade or overhead connector. You can see it, this is a concourse. We have apron here, and these are the aircrafts what has been parked here. So parked in nose arrangement around the satellite, passenger processing is handled in a separate terminal facility. It works very well for heavy activity airport and for large percentage of connecting the passengers. And the example of such type of system you find is you find in Orlando International Airport, you find it in Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta International Airport, in Denver International Airport, and so on, right? So this is how this is all about the satellite system. So finally, to sum up, you can try to understand this in one single picture. We have a simple, this is a terminal, we have a simple here. Then we have a terminal, this is called as linear. Then sometimes you have this curvy, curvy linear as well. Then these are pier finger terminals, right? And then this is pier satellite terminals. You have one portion here and the aircrafts are parked in this way. This is remote satellite terminal, which has been, which is kept in this way. So you can see it here as well, the same thing. So I hope you have got an idea about the aircraft parking layout. So we'll see you back in the next lecture. Thank you.